Right now, the NAMM TEC Award Halls of Fame is filled with a long list of legendary figures from the recording industry, inventors, artists, engineers that have been recognized with this honor for a lifetime achievement that truly made a difference in all our lives. With tonight's first special presentation, please welcome a Grammy Award winning producer and an engineer and a funky, legendary guitar player, recording artist, and Rock and Roll Hall of Famer who signed his first contract 47 years ago. Now, the first name, you have no vowels in your last name. And I had to Google, and Google shut down. And Siri said, you're on your own. I don't know what the hell that is. So I think it's Bill Szymczyk. Bill Szymczyk, which should be Bill Szymczyk. And Joe Walsh, y'all, give it up.
Well, this award is so important, it takes two people to present it.
That's right. 52 years ago, next month, I met Gary Kellgren at Dick Charles Recording Studio in New York City. I'd just gotten out of the Navy and landed a job there for 6 months before I was going to go to college. He had recently gotten out of the Air Force and was just stopping in New York on his way to Paris to write the great American novel. I didn't start college, and he didn't write that novel. The music business kidnapped both of us. We were making 70 bucks a week, but the real money was in cutting publisher acetates called dubs, which we got a 5-cent commission on. We both tried to outdo each other to get the orders for 20 dubs instead of one or two. This competition for nickel a dub was the beginning of our lifelong friendship. Gary introduced me to two wonderful people, his future wife, Marta Rivera, and a gentleman named Fred Nunes. Without Fred, we wouldn't be here tonight because he was the one who introduced Gary to his soon-to-be partner, Chris Stone. And shortly after that, they built the first record plant in New York City, and I introduced Joe to the record plant.
Well, it worked, and they moved to the West Coast and started a record plant West Coast in Los Angeles. It was a safe, state-of-the-art, private place for artists to go and make music and work at their craft. And the list of artists who went through the doors of Record Plant West, and the body of work, the body of the music and the magic of the music is profound. And thank you, Chris and Gary, from all of us.
Hear, hear. But the record plants were not just about consoles and microphones and outboard gear. They were incubators for talented people. Runners could become assistants, assistants could become engineers, and with luck, engineers could become producers. Jack Douglas, Mike Klink, Ron Nevison, Harry Maslin, and Jimmy Iovine, just to name a few. Love him or hate him, he's successful. And of course, the queen mother of all studio managers, Rose Mancherny.
The first project really to come out of Record Plant A was the James Gang.
Rides Again.
The James Gang Rides Again album came out and went to about number 8 and parked. And was on the Billboard charts for 53 weeks. And we were the first people into Studio A, and I just want to tell you, if you ever get a chance to get the vinyl format of James Gang Rides Again and listen to it with headphones on, there is a layer of magic between your ears that the music sat on. And that is Studio A.
Like Joe said, we were the one of the very first to work in Studio A in L.A. And Gary Kellgren had these incredible Tannoy speakers. He was so proud of them. He said, "You're going to love these." And so we went in and we were cutting one of the tunes was called The Bomber, and it's rather loud. And my motto in those days was made loud to be played loud. And it was loud. So at the playback for The Bomber, about eight of those Tannoys went game over. So Gary went to Tom Hidley, his tech at the time, and said, "Make me a monitor Szymczyk can't blow up." And it was the Hidley monitor, and we're responsible for that. Thank you very much. And in the end, it was about two people that changed the way we made records. Gary dreamed it up, and Chris made it happen. We're all indebted to Gary and Chris for making a place that was a safe and crazy ideas for most our most memorable sounds. And if you'd like to watch this video, it'll explain the whole thing. To
the Hotel California. The golden age of the modern recording studio can be traced back to two industry trailblazers, Gary Kellgren and Chris Stone, founders of the Record Plant. There's a red house over yonder, baby. Starting out in 1968, Record Plant New York featured the first living room style studio design and one of the first 12-track recorders. With Jimi Hendrix as its first client, word quickly spread that this was a very special place to make music. There's a new kid in town. Kellgren was the visionary designer and engineer, Stone the business brains and creative enabler. Together they created recording havens for the Eagles. There's a new kid. Stevie Wonder, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Fleetwood Mac, Aerosmith, Bruce Springsteen, Sly and the Family Stone, The Rolling Stones, and solo Ringo, George, Paul, and John. Gary Kellgren made his way to New York City from his Midwestern home in the mid-60s. Where he started out cutting songwriter demos alongside future Eagles producer-engineer Bill Szymczyk. Within a few years, he would become the recording engineer of choice for a brilliant new generation of artists, including Hendrix, Frank Zappa, and the Velvet Underground. Chris Stone was a West Coast MBA grad who worked at Revlon in New York, where he and Kellgren first met through their wives. With a $100,000 outside investment, they built their first studio on West 44th Street. The first album was Electric Ladyland. What do you want from life? By 1969, Los Angeles got its own record plant, equipped with the latest gear, plus luxury comforts like a jacuzzi and themed hotel rooms. Tom Hidley served as chief engineer and developed the famed Westlake monitors that answered the high decibel needs of rock and roll. Kellgren hosted the George Harrison-inspired Jim Keltner Fan Club Hour, a series of Music Insider super sessions. That's the power of love. Record Plant Sausalito, the first studio getaway, opened in 1972, where Fleetwood Mac wrote and recorded Rumors, where Prince made his very first album. With three studio complexes and a fleet of remotes, the Record Plant was everywhere there was music. Their trucks captured the great arena concerts of the day. Nearing the end of the decade, the studio was shocked by tragedy. Kellgren's accidental drowning at his Hollywood mansion in 1977, followed by a devastating fire that leveled LA's Studio C in 1978. However, with the help of studio manager Rose Mann, Stone kept the business afloat, and by the early 80s, it was again thriving, eventually outgrowing the original LA location. In December 1985, the industry celebrated the closing of what some say was the real Hotel California, with hundreds of its artists, producers, and staff coming together for the last jam. The following month, the reborn record plant opened in the former Radio Recorders Annex, an historic studio where Elvis Presley and Louis Armstrong had recorded. 50 years after Kellgren and Stone met, the record plant brand continues to mean music. Countless producers, engineers, and designers were guided by Kellgren's vision. Stone literally wrote the book, The Sound of Money, about how a studio business should be run. And hundreds of Record Plant alumni still remember working there as the best years of their lives.
A lot of the alumni would love to have been up here tonight to do this, but Joe and I copped it because we knew him first.
Yeah, we deserved it the most.
That's right.
Yeah. I just want to say this award is a good 30 years overdue.
Yes. We got some messages from people that couldn't be here, or some are here, and they had something to say. So check this out.
Congratulations, Chris and Gary, on your induction into the Tech Hall of Fame.
Fucking A, Bubba.
No.
I thought that was magic, wasn't it, Archie? That was magic, right? It was from the heart.
Gary and Chris were the magicians of music and money.
The yin and yang of the recording industry.
Stone always managed to stay straight enough to build a record company for every single minute.
They built really a dynasty. They were innovators, they were risk takers. They looked towards the future, and their success is a testament to that.
Gary and Chris were the first people to have a studio that was oriented around the idea that you could enjoy yourself.
The most unique and intensely creative environment.
The impact they had on the business far exceeds anything we can imagine.
I think you're responsible probably for breeding more successful engineers and talent in the business than just about anybody.
The record plant has meant so much to me in my life.
Certainly started my career. Had the greatest time on the planet.
An amazing place that just changed my life.
If it wasn't for Record Plant, I would not be doing what I'm doing today.
I mean, I really feel a big part of my personal professional identity as an adult is Record Plant.
And I'm still in the business because of the opportunity that I got from Chris, and I'll never forget it, and I owe him all my happiness.
It still feels like I should walk in there and go home.
What an era. Adjacent to the studio, a 5-star restaurant, steak tartare and a fine cab. What a way to do biz.
And a place to experiment, and a place to feel uninhibited about what we were doing.
Chris Stone, Gary Kellgren, what more can I say?
Unforgettable.
They deserve this award big time.
Rest in peace, Gary. Chris Stone, live 120 in good health.
And now to accept the Hall of Fame Award for technical excellence and creativity, and the Record Plant was all about those three things, I'd like to introduce Marta Kellgren.
And Chris Stone.
Yes, sir. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
You know, I was terribly afraid tonight. They told me that that Bill and Joe were gonna really give me a bad time and roast me and do all those things like that. And they were so sweet. Don't you think they were sweet? And it's just amazing. On behalf of Gary and Marta, thank you, Bill, thank you, Joe, Karen Dunn, Tech Foundations. But this is a story that goes way, way, way beyond Gary and me and has touched so many. The Record Plant family on the East Coast and the West Coast and all the musicians who called our studios home. The women of the Record Plant are incredible. My wife, Gloria, bless your heart. Yes. Rose Mancini, without which we could have not done. And many others. There are so many bright and talented people who made it all happen. I'm very proud of our Record Plant family and what we were able to accomplish together. Special thanks also to my current partners, David Goggin and Marty Porter, for our nonfiction project, Record Plant Diaries. Based upon hundreds of interviews with former clients and employees during our ownership of Record Plant Studios. Thank you all very much. Marta, where are you?
Thank you, Chris. Oh my God, this is Chris. Hey, for so many reasons, I wish that Gary was here, up here this evening instead of me. One of them being to accept this award himself. He would have loved this, especially to have it be presented by his old friend from the old days, Bill Szymczyk. No doubt they would have had a funny exchange up here tonight. Within a decade, the two of them went to become two of the most respected men in the industry. Bill, one of the greatest producers of all time, and Gary and Chris as having built the sorry, I've got chicken scratch here, I didn't print this. Greatest recording studios of all time, the Record Plant. Believe me, this is a dream come true for his children and me, especially our daughter, Devin, who built the GaryKellgren.com website and who, in her own way, pushed for her father to be honored by the industry, no matter how long it took her. Thank you to all of you who worked with him, with Gary, and loved him. You all know who you are. He loved all of you, too. Many thanks to Joel Amand, Pete Johnston, and Karen Dunn, Mr. Banzai and the Record Plant Diaries Project, and to Chris for keeping the dream alive. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Yeah. Go, girl. You were good. We're going this way.
We're going back here.
Yeah. Okay. Joe, thank you so much.